Our God is greater. Thank you, Father. Our great and mighty God, we worship you. We glorify your holy name. Lord, we just ask that you accept our praise and worship. Because in your word, you said you inhabit in the praise of your people. Thank you, mighty Father. As we study tonight, Lord, open our eyes of understanding. Lord, open up our spirit man. Remove every distraction, every hindrance that could have stopped us from hearing and receiving from you this evening. Lord, let there be a free flow of your word. Let there be an impartation to our spirit man this evening, Lord. Thank you, mighty Father. Holy Spirit, we ask that you have your way. In Jesus' most wonderful name, we have prayed. Amen. Thank you, choir. God bless you. And thank you. We will not have a long session this evening. We will be straight to the point. We want to just go straight to the point as we don't have much time. A little bit cold in here this evening, so we have much of heating to do. Tonight, by the grace of God, we will be, once again, if I go ahead, I welcome you viewers online, and I want to thank God for making even the technology available, even in these times, so that we will be able to hear the word and receive it from wherever we are, as long as we are connected up. We'll be looking at a very important subject. Managing situations. Now, it's very important that this topic, I believe the Lord is bringing it this time, because it's very important that we look at a subject like this in these days, these times we are in. In the things that is happening all around us, the global pandemic, everything, it's good we look at what the scripture says, it won't be a long study, at least we look at four portions of the scripture, and we will be able to draw some lessons from there in managing our situations. Now, my main anchor verse would have been 2 Corinthians chapter 6, from verse 5 to 8. But before we go there, and look at what we have to draw, some lessons we have to draw from there. I will want us to start from the Old Testament, as a matter of fact, and then we can move forward and get to 2 Corinthians chapter 6, 5 to 8. It's a very detailed passage. I just selected, as I was preparing, selected 5 to 8 as the anchor verses, but it's much more than that. Praise the Lord. So, my introduction will be that God himself managed situations. He looked at the people. When God is dealing with us human beings, he knows where you are, he knows where I am, he knows where we are, he knows every situation, every stage, every circumstances that may be facing us. He knows when we are growing. He knows when we are grown. He knows when we have money, when we don't have money. He knows when we have plenty and when we don't have plenty. He knows all those things. And he wants us to manage our situations very well. He wants us to manage the bad times. He wants us to manage success. The successful times. He wants us to manage every stage we are in. Now, if you think I'm making that up, give us Exodus chapter 23, verse 30. What does it say? God is expecting every believer to manage circumstances and manage our situations very well. Now, he said, look at God speaking to the Israelites. Now, the full detail of the story is that he is leading them out of Egypt. And he's giving them the land where they are going to occupy. He said, by little and little, I will drive them out from before thee, until thou be increased and inherit the land. God had all the power to chase all the enemies out at the same time. If we read further, he said, if I do it that way, I'm going to create a good problem for you. I would have finished driving the enemies out, but because you're not large enough, you won't fill out the land. You will have jackals, wild animals, wild beasts will invade the land, and it becomes a problem for you. And he said, I won't drive all the enemies at the same time. I will do it little by little. Why would I do it little by little? Because I'm managing your growth. I'm expecting you to grow gradually or grow as at your rate, at the rate which you are growing, so that you'll be able to fill the land. So I'll drive one area, you'll be able to fill that place. I'll move on to the next place, I'll drive them, you fill it up. Many times, if we can think about that, many times that we are worried about, why is my own progress slow? Why am I not getting this? Why am I not getting that? If we can remember this scripture, that the Lord is saying that, little by little, I will drive them out before you, until thou be increased. There are some things that your capacity cannot handle now. There are some certain things that my capacity may not be able to handle now. God is saying, there is a steady growth. Are they increasing? Yes, they are increasing. It wasn't too much of a difficult thing for God also to say, well, I will rapidly increase you, I will multiply and accelerate your increase. But he said, you will grow and you will inherit the land. That is certain. What God wants to do for us, many times is certain, because it is God. But then, the way we approach it, the way we want to have it, the timings we put to it may not be the timings, the scales we put to it may not be the scales that God is putting to it. He said, until I will drive them little by little until you increase and be able to inherit the land. So God is managing the situation. So he, at this scripture, we can see it. It was not difficult for God to take Joseph after he had had all those dreams and had the dreams. We won't even go to that reference. And stepped straight from his father's house, no Potiphar, no prison, straight into the palace and put him there. It wasn't difficult for God to do, but God was managing, helping him to manage the situation. If he was not effective in serving Potiphar, he would probably be effective in being the leader in the prison, and he would be effective in being second in command to Pharaoh. So there is always a room and capacity for growth that God builds into our life because he's managing our situation. He knows where we are. He knows the stage at which we are at every given time. And to add another one to take us to Philippians chapter 4, verse 12. Managing our situation. So we've seen an example from God. We've seen an example from God. God is managing the situation here. Now look at what Apostle Paul say here. Apostle Paul say, I know both how to be abased and I know how to abound. Paul is saying, perhaps this is one of the qualities of Christians, that, you know, solid Christians, you must know how to handle whatever situation that is you are facing, that is coming your way by the grace of God, particularly when it comes to the polar ends of it. He said, I know how to be abased. When it comes to being abased, when it comes to being that I lack. Now, do you know that many believers don't know how to manage the little money they have at the moment? They are if they have a little problem, they are not yet broke, but they just, you know, they feel they're running out of money, then everything goes wrong. Mood changes, problems, maybe the husband and wife begin to fight because there is no one. Please listen. The speaker, because Paul says, I know how to be abased. It's not fun to be abased. He's not saying I enjoy being abased. Please, let's not get it wrong. He's not saying I enjoy being in lack. No. He's not saying that. He said, I know how to handle it. I know how to manage that situation. By the way, there are many people that if a little thing They will tell you, oh, but you know, they'll be doing pity party, they'll be crying here, seeking, you know, making the matters worse. That shall not be a portion in the mighty name of Jesus. May you know how to handle every situation, that even when there is some little, maybe momentary lack, because the Bible told us that since I was born, 9 years old, the psalmist actually saying that, I have never seen the righteous forsaken. I have never seen the son of the child of the righteous begging bread. So it's out of the creed that we want to have more, that we go into begging. We go into some certain things that may even bring shame to the name of the Lord. Because we are not comporting ourselves very well. Because we are not controlling ourselves very well. May you manage your situation. May I manage my situation very well in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So he said, I know how to abound. I know both how to be abased and I know how to abound. So success is also good to manage it very well. When things are abound now, when there is so much yield, when do you know how to? One man in the scripture, Luke chapter 18, he didn't know how to manage his success very well. He said, now my barn has increased. Now I will do this, I will do this, I will do that. Now, his speech alone disqualified him. God said, this one, because he did not glorify God, that means he didn't even manage his system. God said, this night, your soul will be required from you. So even when it is success, may we know how to manage it very well in the mighty name of Jesus. This situation we are in now, the coronavirus, the pandemic and the problems, are you managing it very well? Are you handling it well? Ask him. Maybe you may need to go back to your prayer point. Maybe you may need to kneel down and say, Lord, help me, give me more wisdom to manage what is coming my way. There are many people that God has blessed. It's even the blessing that is bringing problem to them. Maybe somebody who was saying, I was okay, but now a child has come. And then it's now the child that is the problem. Many people, it's a job that they have been looking for. Job had come. They now say it's a job that is preventing them. Many people, it was husband or wife they were looking for. Now that has come. It becomes an obstacle. Are you managing the situation very well? That's the question. It's a practical study tonight. Managing your situation. I know how to abound. I know how to, I know both how to be abased and I know how to be abound. Everywhere and in all things, I am instructed both to be full and to be hungry. Can you manage being hungry? The church is doing fasting now. And it seems that some people are falling apart. Or some people's faith are falling apart. Can you handle some momentary period of being hungry? This, the good thing about fasting is that you have food. It's not that you lack food, but you now have to decide to stay away from food. Some people, it's a struggle. They can't do that. It's a local area. God will give us grace in the mighty name of Jesus to manage how to be full the day of merriment. Every day cannot be party. Every day cannot be merriment. Every day cannot be full. No. Some days, how to be full and how to be hungry. Both how to abound and to suffer need. Some people, anything, little thing they need, it's just a small thing. It becomes a phone call everywhere, distress call, SOS. Phone this uncle, phone that person, phone that, disturb. No. Some may even go on church strike. I'm not going to church again until God brings that in. May you know how to manage it much and how to manage it. This word is for someone tonight. That's Paul. I've given the example of God managing the situation for Israelite, telling them, I'm going to promote you, I'm going to do this. Generally, we are talking about some people starting a new job. Maybe they just finished from school. And 3 months down the line, they want to become the manager or director of that company. May you manage your situation, manage your peace very well. Hallelujah. Now, there's nothing, I'm not against having a good ambition or great ambition, but be ready that when it does not come in that 6 months time, it will still be cool-headed and doing your best then. So, manage your expectations as well. God will help us to do so in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, the third scripture reference I will take us to before I go to the second Corinthians will be Zechariah chapter 4 verse 10. Zechariah chapter 4 verse 10. Now, that scripture will misquote it a lot. We say, do not forget the days of your little beginning. It's not do not forget the day. It's for who despise the day of small things. It's actually do not forget the day. Do not despise. Do not despise the days of small things. That's another way of managing success, managing situations. The days you have small, the days of small beginnings, the days of small things, do not despise these small beginnings. Thank you very much. Just stay, let's stay there. That top part. God is saying to us, one of the ways to manage our situations, manage circumstances is do not despise. Despise. Don't despise. Mean look down. Don't look down. The days of small beginning, the days of small beginning. The small beginning, the small increment. Don't despise them. Some people are small beginnings, maybe that God is giving us a small job. A job with a small pay. Let me put it that way. It might be a small job. Start from there. Managing situations. From there, God might give you a link. I'm talking about practical things that have happened to people. So it's good I use those practical things. From there, God can, it might not be because of that job that God is, that God is going to keep you there. It might be because there is a link that God wants to establish through that job. It might be that there is something, maybe a person, or something that God wants to open your eyes to see out of that job that is going to launch you into the next level, into the greater level. Manage your situations. If somebody says, oh, no way, me, go get that job, no way, me, do that, me, squeeze myself in that small office, never. That person can be going around in a circle and not getting onto the next stage that God wants to be because he is despising the small beginning. Think the best way to manage that situation is say, Father, thank you for this beginning. Thank you for I'm not advocating that if you have a very big good job that you see this one is going to be great and then you see another small one. It's not a case of this one is there, this one is better. I'm not advising you to think more. But I'm saying if it is the only one that you have in your hand, if it is the one that has come your way, don't kick it out and say, I'm not going to take that one till I wait and get this other one. No. Manage the days of little beginning. Manage the small things, the small beginnings. This is a practical situation. As COVID-19 has come, God may be asking people to start something new, start something afresh, start something in another dimension. Go ahead. This is a word from the Lord. Don't wait until you have everything. One of these big billionaires said that if you are waiting until everything is arranged, you have missed the opportunity already. You might know how to, and it is here in the scripture. Do not despise these small beginnings. And it's a strong word to God, to somebody that God is releasing. Do not despise small beginnings. Because it may be small. In fact, actually in the scripture, we say, though thy beginning might be small, but your latter day shall be greatly increased. Your latter day shall be greatly increased. Managing your situations. Now, take us to, finally, like I said, it's not going to be a long session tonight. Take us to 2 Corinthians chapter 6 from verse 5 to 8. I'll make a few points there. Paul was speaking. He said, in stripes. In fact, give us verse 4 before. Because there's a few things I want. He said, do not be offended. Or verse 3. Start from verse 3. I just read through. Yes. But in all, okay. Verse 3, yes, this is what I want to hear. Now, the first thing that happens goes wrong with us when we lose some track in managing situations with big offense. We're offended at the system, we're offended at our. Look, some people are so offended that they're now blaming their father. That is no more. Some people are blaming their mother. Say, he didn't do this for me. He didn't do this for me. He didn't do this. He said, give me no offense in anything, that thy ministry be not blamed. What he's talking about, he says, give me no offense. Once you start admitting offense, you've already started missing the situation. You're already starting a wrong foot in managing the situation. Please confess, I will give no offense. When he talks about, there are this story of two boys, who went through, of course, from the same two brothers. Their father was an alcoholic who didn't give them any kind of direction in life. He just was drinking here and there. The first guy decided to take after his dad and say, well, he will be drinking. But the other boy said, I have seen the impact of alcohol on my father. I have seen the devastation. I have seen the trouble. How alcohol has wrecked my father's life. I will not subscribe to alcohol at all. I will not taste, I won't even near or smell alcohol. What a way. And he turned out to be a better way. So, he could have taken offense and be blaming his father. You are the one. Any little thing he said, you took me to him. His father had even gone. Give him no offense. He will take no offense in the mighty name of Jesus. Situations come. For those who are prepared, those who are prepared to move forward, they will move forward. Go to the next verse now. Now this man, what he went through, where he said, give him no offense. Listen, he really gave no offense. He really did no offense. But he said, but in all things, approving ourselves as ministers of God, he considered himself as a minister of God. In much patience, where he had to be patient, he was patient. He was managing the situation. In affliction, in necessities, in distress, we have not been through half of what Paul had, what he's talking about here. Afflictions, in necessities, in distresses, not just distress, distresses, plenty of it. In necessities where times he needed things that he didn't have them. But he held together. You will hold together in the mighty name of Jesus. You will not fall apart. Pray, you will not fall apart. So listening to the word of God here, the word of God is going to guide and hold you. You will not collapse, you will not buckle. Next verse, like I said, we're reading through. And then, in stripes, he was flogged on top of that. For the fault of nothing that he had done wrong. For the fault of none of his. He was flogged in stripes, in imprisonments. Why was he going to prison? Because he was preaching the gospel. In tumults, where people just raise uproar against him, mobilize a mob action against him, in labor, in watchings, in fastings. Again, I believe some of those last things he had food, but he couldn't. But some he didn't have food, so he had to just go hungry or go declare fasting. But in all these things, he said, he remembered by pureness, by knowledge, by long suffering, by kindness, and by the Holy Ghost, by love unfailing. This love was really unfailing. The love he had for Jesus Christ was unfailing. And he stood on all these things by the word of truth, by the power of God. I wish we could just load all these things into our life so that we can manage our situations. By the word of truth, by the power of God, and by the armor of righteousness, on the right hand and on the left. He gave this armor on the right and the left. The day that it falls on the lark, he will have it. The day it falls on the march, he will have this armor of righteousness. By honor and dishonor. Sometimes he was disrespected. Sometimes he was trashed. Sometimes he was insulted and talked to the way he's not supposed to be talked to. But he held together. He managed the situation. By evil report and by good report. Evil report means that there are people who blackmailed him. He managed the situation very well. Some of us are just only good when going is good. When people are singing praises and giving us good report and saying nice things about us, we're okay. But any little black man, any little thing, we'll fall apart. No. From today, by the grace of God, we will not fall apart again. We will manage situations very well. That situation when people are praying, letting everyone report, maybe that you just keep quiet and handle it. And ask God and allow God, not even ask, allow God to vindicate you. Allow God to speak on your behalf. And by honor, by dishonor, by evil report and good report. As deceiver, there are deceivers along the way. There are people who came to deceive people. Sometimes he was even perceived as a deceiver himself, as if he was deceiving people, but yet he was true. He was telling the truth. But he was misconstrued. He was mistaken. You manage your situations very well. Are you trying to help somebody and that person is slamming the door in your face and that person is firing it back at your face, throwing it at your face as if you're not managing the situation very well? Praise the Lord. I want us to pray. Like I promised, it's not going to be a long session tonight. The prayer point is simple. Father, help me. We've read a lot. You know, maybe I recommend this 2 Corinthians chapter 6 a little bit more. But just some points. All the things that have been enumerated there. By the word of truth. Give us that verse 5 again that had a lot of things there. Let's pray with them. Say, Father, endue me. Fill me up with these things. Fill me up with these things. In 2 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 5, I was looking for. Verse 5 and 6. Lord, fill me with these virtues. Fill me with the capacity to manage my situations. Even when the going is good and when the going is not good. When in much and when in little. When in lack and when in full. Lord, help me that I will manage my situation. Help me that I will not despise the days of my little beginning. I will not despise my small beginning. Because my latter days shall be greatly increased. Father, help me to understand that even as Paul is saying here, that he is not taking offense, he is not falling apart because some people talk like him, because some people misconstrued him. Father, help me to manage every situation. Help me to manage the situation that is coming tomorrow and the one that is coming to next month, the one that is coming to the rest of the year and onward. Help me, Lord. Even if I'm going to start small, I say maybe a small business idea, from there there will be expansion. Help me, Lord, that I will not discard what I'm supposed to manage very well. Thank you, mighty Father. In Jesus' most wonderful name, we have prayed. Father, we thank you. As many that have received this word, letting you the fruits that you proposed by sending it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, mighty Father, for in Jesus' most wonderful name we have prayed. Amen. Please give your offering to me, and the Lord will bless all our offering, and you will bless our apostles, and we will have reward in hundreds of folds in the mighty name of Jesus Christ we have prayed. Amen. Let's share the grace together. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Remember, we are on broadcast again on Sunday, 11 a.m. God bless you.